For those of you who have been following my work, you know that I'm all about the community. What better way to get to know a community than to speak with the people that help feed them? I had the opportunity to visit Progressive Teamworks Outreach, also known as the Food Bank in Zeblin. I had the pleasure to speak with Pastor Herbert Gray. Pastor Gray shares how long he has been involved in food distribution and how he got started.
I've been doing it for 18 years, but how it got started, probably about 23 years ago, Bishop John Mangum, who is the founder of the church, he and his brother started it in their backyard. And so they used to deliver food to people, so we've expanded from that to what we have today, and we'll service probably about 150 families today.
And for those who may be wondering about the requirements to receive food?
There are no requirements. All we ask is your name, your address, and the number of people that are in your family. Prior to the pandemic, we had drive-through service. And so they come, they get in line. While they're in the line, we typically have someone to go through and get the information that's needed. And then once the information is documented, they just drive around and we put the boxes in their vehicles so they never have to get out of their car.
They provide a variety of food.
Typically, anything that you can find in a grocery store, we'll have a lot of those items here. This past Tuesday, we got a case full of eggs, and as most people know, eggs are pretty expensive, so we were able to bless everyone with a minimum of 2 dozen of eggs. So we get a variety of things. It's not the same thing every week, but we almost always have vegetables. We almost always have bakery items, and here within the last several weeks, we had an abundance of canned food we've been passing out.
I spoke with Lewis Latin, one of the volunteers. He shares what keeps him coming back to volunteer.
I'm from Rocky Mount, North Carolina, and I make that drive every week to come out here to assist the pastor and the other volunteers. We've got about, I guess, 1/3 of the volunteers are veterans. From the very first time I came out, I was hooked. I knew this is what I wanted to do. It feels great because I know I'm helping someone who really needs it.
As cars lined up, I decided to speak with a few people who were waiting in line.
The food bank has been a blessing to the neighborhood. It's been a blessing to me and my family. And just like today, I'm here for someone else because they don't have no transportation and they really need food. And it's a lot of people out there that, you know, need food and need help and don't have transportation. So I come here for myself, and I also come here for other people.
The food bank and everything, that's great for the community. Ain't nothing no better than helping people out, as long as myself, helping me, because I rely on the food bank also. Now, I pass it out to other people, not for just me, you know. It's a great idea, great thing to do. People that volunteer to give out the food and stuff, they need praise. Need to give them praise for what they do because they don't have to do it.
I think he's doing a very good job for the food bank because sometimes people don't know where to go and they can't. Some people, since it had gone up, some people come here and don't have to pay anything. And that's a blessing because some people got children and that help feed the children.
This is my first time here. My mom usually comes. I'm excited to see what I get. I don't know, I'm ready, but my mom usually comes, like I said, and I happen to be free this afternoon, so I decided to come check it out myself.
It's a blessing for people like us, especially in the country, that sometimes we don't have a way to get to the supermarket because sometimes you don't have a ride, you don't have the money, and maybe the government can do something. And I appreciate your work very much, and it's a blessing, it really is, because I don't have to go to sleep hungry tonight.
With the price increase of food and the cost of living, the number of families in need has also increased.
18 years ago when we first started, we may would have serviced 25 families, but 18 years later, we do about at least 150. And so it's more than just the Zeppelin area. We have people from Nash County, Franklin County, all the surrounding counties, Raleigh, Clayton. So we have people from all over that come.
The one thing I like about the food bank, they give me stuff that I wouldn't normally buy. Because I'll be trying to scratch my money and pitch my pennies. And it's just been a blessing, you know.
You know, a lot of places need to step up and do this kind of thing for certain people because groceries are so high now, people can't afford it.
For some people, there's a stigma associated with going to the food bank. Pastor Gray reminds us that there is no shame in receiving help when you need it.
We've had people literally come through and start to cry because they have to come to a food pantry. There's no shame in needing help. The shame is not reaching out for that help.
As I spoke with the people, I could tell they were full of gratitude.
I thank y'all very much.
I'm thankful. I'm sure I see a lot of people come here. They thankful too.
And for those interested in volunteering,
we are always looking for healthy young volunteers. Most of the volunteers we have right now are retired. We're all senior citizens, but we are blessed with a great team of people. If there's someone who wants to volunteer, there's some minimal training that we want you to go through. We'll take you through that training just on how to deal with people. There's some federal regulations we have to abide by, and so that's very minimal, but we are always looking for and would love to have some young people, high schoolers or college people, because we want to impart upon them the importance of giving and giving back and being a blessing to the community.
It's a blessing. It's no more than that. It's a blessing.
We have never, ever run out of food. Nobody has ever driven off this complex without receiving food.
I really enjoy speaking with the community, and I really appreciate Pastor Gray and his ministry for how they give back to the community. They are definitely making a difference in people's lives, one food box at a time. For East Wake TV, I'm Monica Cooper, keeping you updated and informed.